Welcome to Strand Trees. Today we're gonna be talking about some ropes. Now, there's a lot more to a rope than just its length and its girth. To get the right function out of your rope, you really need to understand its construction. So that's what we're gonna be talking about today, both for rigging and for climbing. So most of this video is gonna be about rope construction, like how the braiding works, what type of braiding, what are these types of construction good for. There's a whole nother conversation to be had about the material type, and we can dive into that in another video, although I'll probably touch on it lightly with this one. We'll start with the oldest tried and true, the three strand. This is really only a rigging line, and let's dive in. So a three strand, as you can see, is made of three primary strands. There's actually a whole bunch of other small strands. Like even these three primary strands are made up of other smaller strands. And those are made up of the smaller strands. They get smaller and smaller. The beauty of a three strand rope is that I can see when the wear is happening. Because each of these strands share a proportional amount of the load and they share a proportional amount of the wear. If this slides in a crotch or on, like if I'm using some natural crotch rigging in a tree, as it starts to get fluffy, that wear gets distributed pretty evenly. And I can see how much damage the rope has taken fairly obviously just by looking at it from the outside, because it's a solid braid of rope that's made up of these three strands. So there's some severe downsides to this. Obviously, because it's twisted, if you pull on it, it'll tend to untwist. So if you put a pulley on this thing, you'll twist up your pulley. If you're doing a lot of rigging with heavy stuff, it'll want to spin. It also has a lot of stretch. So if you're dealing with tight confines and you're not able to take all that stretch out of the rope, that'll be a problem as well. The primary advantage of this construction is that it's cheap. They're cheap and they're pretty durable. They hold up well to that kind of natural crotch rigging. I'll do that with something simple like this and cheap. And if it wears out fast, who cares? It's like 30% less than a double braid. So this is a solid braid because it is all solid and it's called three strand. It's got three primary strands. Think lots of twist, old school, don't climb on it. Can be okay for some light rigging. Can be okay for some big rigging, heck. You just know that you're gonna wear through it a little bit faster and it's got those downsides. So next we have a rope that you all should be familiar with, but especially old timers. This is also a solid braid. So we'll get into the distinction between solid braids and double braids, but this is also a solid braid. It's a 16 strand. And this one is called, let's see, Safety Blue, I think. Yeah, Safety Blue. Of course, it's orange and white, but they call it that because it's got this little blue core strand on the inside. Now, like the three strand, the solid braid is good for natural crotch rigging, and it's nice for easy inspection because all of the load-bearing strands, again, are on the outside. So it's you can tell just by looking at it how much wear it's taken. Now, it's also because of the way it's braided and not just twisted, this tends to be a lot more stable when you load it. It doesn't twist quite as bad, but it is still much more dynamic than the other modern ropes. And as far as its strength to weight goes, it's a little bit heavier, can't hold quite as much weight for its size. This was kind of a big leap forward from the three strand. A lot of you guys will still run this. It's not a bad light rigging rope. And a lot of guys learn to climb on this because you can Blake's hitch it and it's got good friction properties. It's kind of bumpy and uneven for when it comes to running through hardware, but it is pretty simple, pretty reliable, pretty tough, and also fairly inexpensive. But again, it's not got great strength to weight. You can get lighter, smaller ropes with a lot more strength, and it's much more dynamic. So if you're climbing SRT, not gonna be fun. Super bouncy. So on a solid braid like this, again, the load-bearing strands are on the outside. This one actually has a blue core that is supposed to make it more obvious if the rope gets damaged, because if you see blue, you know it's been damaged through the load-bearing strands. But this core is not actually designed to be load-bearing. It plays very little factor in the strength of the rope as a whole. So when you splice these guys, you'll see it'll look like a really floppy splice because it's actually just the cover. But that helps it hold its shape, helps keep it round, and it gives it a little bit of extra safety factor. But you can see here all of the individual strands. Like I said, it's a 16 strand, because you've got 16 different strands around the outside of the cover. So this is Snotch Sasquatch. It's another 16 strand solid braid. It's basically the same construction, but this will be a slightly larger diameter. And I just use it for rigging sometimes, although they say you could use it for climbing. I would not generally do that. This one, like that orange rope, also has a core to it, but it's white, so it's hard to tell. Another type of construction we see is the hollow braid. So here I've got some dynamic cabling, and you can see it like is really flat. It's kind of two-dimensional, and that's because it's hollow. You can really tell a hollow braid by the way you can bunch it up and see it kind of scrunch like a Chinese finger trap. And then you know that it's hollow, it's got no core. But this is the load-bearing part of the rope, so it's actually like this, except without the core in it. So it tends to be flat. You'll see it more often in slings because it makes for some really easy splicing. This is some hollow braid Dyneema or UHMP rope. This is a sling that we use for our porta wrap. And you can see if I bunch it together, pretty cool. Super easy to splice, great for making nice slings. Tends to be extra strong. So this type of construction is really strong for its weight, but it doesn't run well. You wouldn't want to use it as a primary rigging line where there's a lot of movement. And it doesn't run through pulleys very well because of the way it flattens. It doesn't, it also has very little dynamic property to it at all. So it tends to be very static, which is cool for slings where you need to lift and you don't want a bunch of stretch, but that's not good for your rigging line. You want those to stretch a little bit because that stretch absorbs the energy involved with your rigging that you're doing. Last line I want to talk about here for rigging is a double braid construction. And at first glance, this might look very similar, but when you actually cut it open, the important thing to know about a double braid is that I've got a braid on the outside, and on the inside, there's a core, and it also has a braid. Now, the thing about double braids is the load on the line is shared between the core and the cover. So if you see damaged cover, that does indicate some damage, but it's hard to know whether or not you've actually ruined the rope completely, because sometimes you can have the core damaged, but not the cover, and have the rope be not worth half of its rated weight if that's the case. So damage is not as obvious, but these are actually much stronger for their weight and for their size. They tend to stay round nicer. They're more supple, more pliable. They've got nicer feel in hand. They knot more nicely. They run through hardware better. So there's a lot of advantages to a double braid, though they are slightly harder to inspect. So let me show you this one here. Here we've got, I'm gonna pull the core out and hopefully you can see. So this is the cover, this is the core, and the core here is actually braided together. It's individual strands, but you can see that they don't just separate out. It's actually a hollow braid in and of itself, which is pretty cool. That also means you can splice it. This is a terrible splice that I did that didn't go well, but you can generally splice a double braid, which is kind of nice. Another distinction you'll see sometimes on your lines is a strand count, which generally refers to the cover. So this is like a 24 strand double braid, which is a very common construction and description of a climbing line, but this is in fact a rigging line. And rigging lines are rated differently. They won't have the same testing requirements as a climb line, so you do want to keep those separate. Any rigging line that you use that's generally, I don't know, we don't usually call them bull lines unless they're bigger than a half an inch, but a bull line is generally a rigging line, a double braid, something that's maximized for strength. And when you're choosing a rigging line, you really want to pay attention to the materials. So there's the construction and the materials, and just to summarize it very quickly, something that is all polyester will tend to be very static, will lift well if you're using GRCS, if you're using as a pull rope. Static is nice, you waste less energy, the transfers energy more directly. Nylon, or often called polyamide, is the other primary material used in these ropes. That tends to be stretchier, it's a little bit more durable, it is a little more sensitive to UV, but it is a little bit stronger for its weight, so you can get slightly higher strength ratings out of a nylon rope, but the biggest advantage is that it's got some stretch to it, a little more stretch than the polyester. So if you've got a rope that you do a lot of negative rigging on, that's a good rope to use a nylon or a polyamide based rope versus an all polyester rope. Those are what you need to know. You got your double braids, your solid braids, which include your 3-strand and your 16-strand solid braid. And then you've got your hollow braids, which are generally for slings, or for, in this case, for setting a dynamic cable for easy splicing, and get out there and rig safe.